Hello, folks. This is Greg Lawrence here at Austin Boats and Motors right here in Lakeway, Texas. That's 512-263-2811. Give us a call anytime. Today, we are going to be going over the beautiful and luxurious Ranger 521L. This is a Z boat. It is a Comanche, and it is beautiful. So, among some of the things that we're going to be looking at today, of course, we've got the Minn Kota Ultrax up front right there with the beautiful trolling motor. We've got the leaning post in the front and two larger redesigned bucket seats, as well as your seat in the back, fishing seat right here. All high quality vinyl, all constructed in-house at Ranger. This boat is sitting on a Ranger Trail trailer. And they've got some pretty neat features on them right now. You've got a swing tongue down here. It's gonna help you get it in your driveway or in your garage a little bit easier. The jack, you're not gonna bang your knee on this jack because the jack folds up on the interior of the trailer. It's a kind of a unique design by Ranger. These trailers are designed and made in-house. You've got Ranger road armor on those trailers. Custom fiberglass fenders. And of course, we've also got the custom wheels on this particular trailer. As we start to step around the backside of this boat, you're gonna notice right away that we've got two of the blade power poles on the back of this guy. And that is a 250 Pro XS by Mercury powering this. Mercury has a stainless steel propeller on there. It's a 24 pitch. We do have a stainless steel boarding ladder, so if you want to hop in those hot days when it's nice and warm, you hop in the water, climb back in the boat pretty easily. Lots of stainless steel on this boat. You're going to see stainless steel for your bilge holes, stainless steel pop-up cleats, all stainless steel hardware for the doors, and of course stainless steel grab handles for the passenger up here. In addition to that, there's some features here on the back. Never worry about if your plug is in or out. You have a cord right here that will always help put your drain plug in for you right on the back of the boat. No diving in the water or reaching in through the hull access. You do have your gauge right here on back that's gonna help tell you what your charge is on this charging system, as well as an outlet right here for you to charge with. This does come with C-Star, I believe, hydraulic steering on the back and a manual jack plate. Excuse me, yep, back here. This is a 50th anniversary boat. So Ranger in business now for 50 years, designing boats 1968 to 2018. You're gonna notice right on the front right there, that is a Helix 12. So these dashes are quite large, do have a locking glove box over here, and it's gonna have an Infinity stereo system in it. So you're gonna have some really killer sounds. If you look over here on the far wall over there is your keypad. You're gonna notice the keypad is how you start this boat. No key needed. So that's actually a really cool feature. So the distinctive Ranger Comanche L series designs feature new hull and deck styling. So you're gonna have ultra comfort bucket seats, these guys right here, a new digital ignition keypad we just discussed, redesigned stern grab handles and consoles, LED lights throughout this boat. So you're gonna see lots of lights throughout this boat. The interior and the trailer are gonna have those lights, and they're gonna be for functional beauty that sets you apart. So, we are going to take a look at the interior of this boat. And here's that Minn Kota. It does have iPilot. It's a 112 Ultrax with the iPilot. So you've got your puck up here, and you've got the recessed navigation lights in the front here, which are nice on both sides. There is your puck. So your iPilot can work with the GPS system. This, in the nose here, you've got your recessed footwell for your ergonomic control. It's not gonna tire you out as much when you're here on the leaning post. You're gonna have a rod holder, optional strap right here. That strap's gonna help you when you are gonna just race to the next spot. You don't wanna put your rods up. Of course, you have a tray right here with your cup holder, your stainless steel cup holder, and your areas for pliers and other tackle. Here's gonna be your Hummingbird. We've got a 9-inch up here in the front. So you're set to go, and you've got a bunch of switches here that are going to help you out with your lights, as well as your trim, and your looks like your live well as well. So got some good stuff. Now this system right here, here's one. This does come with a spare custom wheel, so mounted on the side, but. You're gonna notice over there it says PVRS, and that's gonna stand for a system that is throughout the compartments here, that the rod compartments, that is going to dry out anything in those compartments. And once we get in the boat here, you're gonna be able to see that a little bit easier. So as we walk over here, we're gonna take a little bit closer look at the Hummingbird big 12-inch that we have, the Helix. And once again, we're gonna look at this keypad right here as well. So let me hop in the boat and we'll check some additional stuff out. Okay, we're back. Here you can get a good look of the custom cover that does come with this boat, as well as right behind it, you're gonna see some of the Infinity speakers that we have. And I'll go ahead and show you real quick the Infinity speakers, the Infinity deck that you have in the glove box. Here's the deck. There's also audio jacks as well as auxiliary jacks in there. Do have a strap as well as a rod holder here on the passenger side. This is going to show you the larger redesigned seating. We'll get a backup off here in a little bit, but that's kind of an up close. It does have the coin box right here in the middle. The coin box is going to be a small storage area that you're going to have with the slam latch. So just slam that sucker down when you're ready to close it. If you look back here in the back, you've got all kinds of extra storage as well as your live well. So we're gonna get our live well open right here. This is a two-sided live well with a divider, so you can kind of set it up with your fishing partner there. And you've got both sides of your live well right here. Divider on the inside that you can remove if you'd like. Good size live well. Now on either side you're going to have these compartments that you'll see right here. And Ranger's gone to using a rubber mat in these compartments so that your stuff stays put. Still see your drain over in the corner. And that's going to be the same over here on this side. Now on this side we've got a little bucket that comes with Ranger. It's going to have a bunch of your cleaning products as well as your high performance Lucas Marine products. But we'll shut that down. Here in the back, you're gonna see, this is our battery switch, and it's also gonna be our 4 15-amp bank battery charger right there, as well as our additional batteries. So lots of good stuff right here. Here's gonna be your oil reservoir, where you wanna put your oil. And as we move to the front, let me tell you a little bit about some of the statistics of this boat. This is a 21-foot, 7-inch boat with a 97-inch beam. This is, it's gonna have overall beam with the rub rails 98.5. The engine shaft length on this boat is gonna be a 20-inch shaft length. So the inside depth of the boat, 21 inches, it can hold 53 gallons of gas. And the live well is gonna hold 31 gallons. Ooh, a little lightning there. See, we're good on this boat, rain or shine. I don't know about lightning though, so we might have to stop here in a second. But the approximate boat weight of this boat right here is 1925, so 1,925. Woo, all right. So we've got a center rod box with a 9-foot capacity, and the port is an 8-foot capacity. So, and then the starboard is a 7-foot foot capacity. We've got a max of 5 people can ride on this thing at, legally at any one time. And on the trailer, it's 102 inches wide in case you're gonna look at putting this in your garage. So we're gonna go ahead and let this rain kind of die down. Maybe I won't get struck by lightning, and we'll be back to look at the front of the boat. All right, we're back. I'm staring at the front of the boat from up close. Right now, you've got some kind of a tool station on either side of your cooler. And that is the cooler right here. Of course, if you want to make sure you've got you've caught the right fish, here's our measuring tape right here. Slides right in. It's nice and conveniently located right here. So we're going to close that cooler. Now you're looking at the center rod box. Center rod box, it's going to have two rows. Two rows of 5. So you've got lots of rod storage. But take careful notice of the sides. You have the PVRS system right here that's going to help dry your wet rods while they are inside your compartment, so you never have to worry about that. The system actually extends throughout the boat. Here's another basically fish box or potential cooler as well. And here's going to be the port rod box. Yeah. Port rod box right here. It's going to hold 9 rods, as you can see right there. We'll look back here, see how they're attached. Also, PVRS system. So this is going to be one of the compartments, as you can see on this side as well, that's going to have the airflow go through it. That airflow essential to keeping all of your equipment, rods, everything mold free. This has also got the system, as you'll be able to see through the back right there. This is the starboard rod area, and it's going to have, you know, boxes for our Helix 9, as well as some of the other components that we've put in this boat. So they're kind of blocking access right there at the time being. Now, this is going to be our optional rod strap. We've got one on either side over here. It's going to help you get where you're going with your rods right here quickly and easily. We've got two spots right here forward. You want to move forward a little bit with your lean post, or maybe perhaps a seat. We've got two options here, one where it's in and one right in front of it. For your holes, once again, 50th anniversary boat, beautiful boat. And I guess I've gone over probably most everything about this particular boat. Let me talk a little bit about some of the extra. Well, I tell you what, since it's raining, we're gonna try to cut this a little bit short. Thank you guys for watching. This is the Ranger Z521L series boat. And you can find this at Austin Boats and Motors. I'm Greg Lawrence. Come over and check us out. We're at Highway 620. We carry Ranger boats, Taiga boats. We carry Blue Waves, Nautic Stars, and Avalon Luxury Pontoons, as well as Crown Line. So if any of those boats sound like something you'd like to have more information about, you can contact us at 512-263-2811. We look forward to serving you.